Happy Sunday, happy Sunday, happy Sunday. Look who is back in front of the camera in 3D, honey, in 3D. It is I, Black Storm, your host. When we come back, we are going to get this show started. See how that says hello? Hello, y'all, hello. Let's roll. For the past couple of weeks, I did not feel like being on camera, but something has gone on since then that made your girl have to appear in front of the camera again. A few things. You all know we have supposedly a new president, but I guess something is going on. I don't even want to get involved in that because my channel is not about politics, so. For now, they're saying Joe Biden as of this recording, but we'll see. We'll see. Moving on. Another thing that I wanted to say was Biggie Smalls being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Now, usually I'm a nice person and I don't like to get... I can't come on here and lie to you guys, but I'm known for being on Facebook and Instagram, putting my two cents in only when I see something that is not right. Okay, I'm not really, I know some people label me a troublemaker. I remember I was in one of the, and this person's probably watching, hey bitch, that's right bitch, you, I'm talking to you. Okay, I remember she came at me the wrong way and I had to cut her ass, I had to cut her, I had to let her know where I was coming from, all right? You can say what you want to say, but when I come back, all right, I come for the jugular. Okay, now, one thing that I did not like or appreciate was that I saw that they were congratulating Biggie Smalls for being inducted into the the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And there were a lot of people in there saying that he's not rock and roll, he never sang rock and roll, you don't see Kiss, the group in there. To me, Kiss is heavy metal. When I was coming up, they was known as a heavy metal. There's a difference between rock and roll and heavy metal. And some of these groups, you know, they were known as metalheads. Out of the old school like me, we know that we had metalheads against the rap heads because we was all into the Dougie Freshes. We was into the Biz Markies, KRS-One, LL Cool J. If you want to go back further than that, Houdini. Remember, we had the Fat Boys, Curtis Blow. That's how old I feel that I am. I'm so, you know, I remember seeing Crush Groove, one of the first rap music movies into the theaters. This was before Crush Groove came out, before Beat Street and Breakin'. Remember Breakin'? They had Breakin' 1 and 2. Boogaloo Shrimp, the Electric Boogaloo. We used to dance to all of that. I'm older to remember seeing Back to the Future. The first one in 1985, I was 17 years old. I'll be 53 next month. Can you believe how good I look for 52? Aren't I cool looking for 52? But anyway, I remember seeing Back to the Future in the theaters back in 1985, and I was like, wow. 2015, remember they were showing how, and I hope there's no feedback in this microphone, so I'm going to hold it like this so I don't get feedback. But I remember... 2015, saying, being 17, like, wow, 2015, but 2015 was, what, 4 years ago? Now we're in 2020, the end of next month, we will be in 2021, and we're still going back and forth, everybody, still going back and forth over rap music, over rock and roll. It's the same thing, it's the same thing. I mean, they didn't like rock and roll when it first came out. Rock and roll was known as race music. It was known as jump bunny music because it was in the black community. It was known as black music. And now, here we are in 2020, people are saying, yet again, what does not belong in Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Rock and roll itself didn't belong at one time. Remember, go back to the 50s. Check it out. Do your homework. You know what? Find out where rock and roll originated, you know? And I tried to come on you know, I went into there saying that nice and, oh, and you know what they said, oh, you're making it about race. It's not about race, people. It's about the origin of rock and roll. It's about who created it. It's about being respectful of the forefathers, Chuck Berry, Lou Richard, Fats Domino. That's who created rock and roll. Rock and roll created rap. Rock and rap is a combination of rock and roll and the blues and R&B, you know what I mean? That's all, you know, that's basically what I was saying. And a lot of the people just came at me, you know, you're making this about race, it's not about this, it's not about that, they should have, make it a new name, the Music Hall of Fame. I think the rock and roll is about music, period, you know, of different genres. Let me know in the comments, am I wrong? How do you feel about Biggie Smalls being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? They even made a big deal about Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston being into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, you know, saying she's not rock and roll. Who makes up these things? You know what I mean? Who says these things? You know, I think Whitney Houston, Biggie Smalls, whoever else, didn't they just put N.W.A. into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? And their music is very controversial. We all know what they said about the police. You know, no one made a big stink about that, but when it came to Whitney Houston, and now when it comes to Biggie Smalls been dead since 1997, and his music still reigns supreme today. Okay, it still reigns supreme. Rap music came out in, what, the 70s, so you're talking almost 40 years ago, and it's still being played. All that other music is on the oldies channel, the oldies but goodies channel, you know what I mean? Rap music is still, and I don't call it hip-hop, because when I was coming up, it was called rap music, and that's what I still say today. I call it rap music. Rap music had, it was for the youth of the streets, okay? It had a message. It had meaning until it started to get watered down and started to go mainstream. You know, now it's not the same anymore. They put in so many different people calling themselves rappers, and they're really not rappers. You know, Busta Rhymes is one of my men. I still like Busta Rhymes. He came out with a new album. Check it out. It's a cool, cool album. Now, I'm not going to talk you guys' ears off, but I just wanted to address the people that had the nerve to go into on Biggie Smalls' page and Facebook and up and down in the comments talking about how he does not deserve to be put in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. You know, why isn't Kiss in there? There's plenty of groups that belong in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame that we haven't seen make it into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but you don't see people going into the comments and saying that they don't deserve to be in there. Who gives you the right to say who deserves to be in there, who deserves to be inducted, and who deserves to be celebrated? Biggie Smalls put in his work. Yes, he was only in it for a little while, but his work stands the test of time, and so does Whitney Houston. And to me, they both deserve to be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. If you don't like it, too damn bad. This is Black Storm telling you thank you so much to the people that come on here. I apologize if I hurt anybody's feelings. If you have any animosity, I mean, that's on you, you know. But for the ones, I thank you for coming here and watching this. Please remember that Sunday brunch isn't just for Sunday. You can watch it Monday through Sunday, or anytime you want to see a great video. You know the Black Storm is always coming at you with what? Love, peace, and soul. I will see you guys next week for another Sunday brunch videos. Put down in the comments if you think that Biggie Smalls should be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'll see you next week, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. To your old lady. Girl, I was trying to tell you. Hey, y'all, how y'all doing? To Jada Stevens taking over for Black Storm's channel.
what's this I hear about everybody up in arms about Biggie Smalls being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Child, don't y'all know who invented rock and roll? Honey, I was there, girl. Little Richard, goodbye to Miss Molly. She'll act about, hey. And Chuck Berry, be good, Johnny, be good. Hey, honey. I don't even know what the hell I'm gonna say. John, I'm trying to tell you, the girl got more excuses than Donald Trump losing the election. That's what I'm telling you, honey. Hey, y'all, how y'all doing? To Jada Stevens taking over from Black Storm Channel. I don't know what I'm gonna say.